We're going to start with the English-speaking media. All Dutch-speaking media, please hold your questions. We'll have a separate scrum for you guys, if that's all right. But let's get started.
I won't
put
that on.
Have you heard anything about this Rory McDonald boy? I know you asked for it in your
We're going to call him Chicken Rory.
Let him come.
That's the fight we want. And I do respect him a lot. He's a tough fighter, but... we're gonna push for that fight, and we're gonna call him names until he takes the fight.
Scott Coker said he's been blowing up his phone since you took that win today. Has he said anything to you about that?
No, I just say congratulated. We were just happy taking pictures with the president and the friend, and I don't know. But yeah, I don't know. There's too many fights to make. There's too many big names. But I don't know. We'll see.
Dago, was there anything at all that surprised you in there tonight? Because obviously you ran through and without much resistance. So was there anything that sort of took you off guard? Was it as expected?
No, I know I was physically stronger. If guys are not on steroids, I'm twice stronger than them. That's the truth. I fought. There were two guys maybe stronger than me, and one of them got caught, and the one was I don't know, very suspicious. But I train with heavyweights. I train with my friend Ricardo. There's the guy. Look at him, handsome, handsome. And yeah, what can I say? He was orthodox, so I had to keep the distance. Yeah.
You said you wanted to call Rory some names until he, you know, until he gets
maybe
to the fight.
Maybe
Rory.
Mac Rory. Nick Mac Rory. He'll come up with something.
Eat it.
But no. Like I said, I like Rory. I think he's a phenomenal fighter, but it's a good matchup for me, I believe, and a big name, and I think fight fans want to see that fight.
Scott was just talking about potentially going to Amsterdam.
Yeah.
I'm sure you'd like to headline that card, right?
Yeah, 100%. If they go there, we have phenomenal fighters, we have good kickboxers, we have Melvin Mono signed again, so we have my friend Castillo. We can headline. We have a lot of stars, you know, so we can headline for sure. Yeah.
Okay, back in your UFC days, you felt you had to change the way that you dealt with the media and be a lot more forthright and a lot more open in the things that you said in order to try and get the title fight that never happened. Now you're in Bellator. You're holding the belt right now. What are we going to see from Gegard Mousasi now?
Nothing. I don't know. It feels the same if it would have been UFC belt or not. I worked to this point. I'm happy. I'm going to take a break, get some booze. And, I'm going to drink, party. And I don't know. I'm just happy. Maybe a light heavyweight, but those guys are big. But I take kickboxing fights, whatever the Bellator offers me. Because with Bellator, you have kickboxing, you have I can go up. And this belt will open some doors for me. And it's all about the opportunities, you know. I have to fight contenders, but you have also big names. I'd rather make Rory than the other guy. He's a good fighter. He's bald, but I don't know his name. He's the contender, I think, now. But he's ugly.
Gegard, everyone always talks about the dream and Strikeforce championship. Everyone talks about, you know, the dream and Strikeforce championships as defining your career and such a long wait to capture another championship. Did you need one more to certify you at the top of the sport?
I think, a belt is who's the better fighter that night, because the best fighter doesn't have always the belt. It's just timing. Like I said, George St. Pierre became the champion because he fought Michael Bisping. That was a good timing for him to take the fight. That was good management. I think any other fighter, maybe GSP wouldn't have won it. So it doesn't say a lot, but of course, for the... It says something and it says not everything. So yeah, it's a belt. I'm gonna make pictures with my belt now. I'm gonna be happy. Yeah.
So Gegard, this is the fifth world title, if I'm correct, or is it no? Six?
I have six belts now. I have three from Dream, Cage Warrior, Strikeforce, Bellator. So I fought two belts in UK, one in three in Japan, and one in US.
And where do you think capturing the Bellator middleweight championship puts you in the conversation for greatest middleweight of all time?
My goal was never to be the best middleweight. I never had that desire. I just wanted to make money. You know, I'm being honest. People saying pride, honor. I don't know. I'm fighting for my family, myself, and I just want to win. That's my. I want to compete and win. But my goal was never to be the best. But you know, my goal is to win all my fights. So if that happens, you know, I don't know. But I'm not there yet.
How much does it mean to have got to this point with a lot of the coaching staff and people have been with you for a very long time on this journey? Now you're standing there with the gold belt.
Yeah, they're friends. They're friends first, and then coaches. You know, they really care about me. I would say more like family, because everyone was worried about me. Don't harass him. Get out of his room. Give him sleep. You know, I see that throughout the whole week. They all really care about me. I love them. And like I said, it's I feel like a team effort, and I'm grateful to them. Otherwise, like I said, my mother, my brother, my coaches, my mother makes every day food. So if she doesn't make food, you know, I can't perform. So, you know, I think everything, you have the whole team to get to the point where I am. But my mother is more than just making food, of course.
Gego, there is one fight out there that could interest you.
Yeah.
Mo Lawal has said that he wants to go back down to middleweight.
Yeah.
Or go to middleweight.
Yeah.
That's a great.
100%. That's a good fight. But I heard, I don't know if it's true, but they said he can make middleweight. But obviously, he's coming to middleweight. That would be a good challenger if he's the contender.
It's that kind of level for you, isn't it?
Yeah. He's a world class fighter. You know, he was the first guy I really didn't dislike, because he was so annoying. But I respect him. He's a fighter.
Light heavy, wasn't it?
Light heavyweight, yeah. And like I said, he was strong. He was really strong. But like I said, next fight, he got popped for steroids. So don't. Yeah, if he's clean and he's the contender for sure, you know. Like I said, but I do respect him. I think I got nothing bad wishes, you know.
Next time we'll talk him out.
If there's Dutch media you want to ask some, throw in some Dutch questions, you're more than welcome.
Can I just quickly ask? You said on the run up to the fight that you were more nervous than normal. What did you put down to that? And did you feel that at all when you were kind of making your walk out and, you know, in the cage there?
Oh, I know. Once the bell rings, I fight. Once the bell rings, I'm not scared. I'm not nervous. You can have all that feelings, but once the ring bells, it's automatic pilot. So it doesn't. But I was nervous because I came to Bellator from USC, and first fight was a little bit difficult. People gave me crap about that. But friends are here. Fighting for the belt, like I felt like I've worked to this moment. So yeah, I was nervous, but you know, so it's okay. I know I can deal with it, yeah.
Yeah, guys, you before this fight, you briefly talked about the future and possibly retiring. This is your 53rd fight, if I'm correct. How much longer do you foresee yourself going on?
I have four fights left, and I think after that, it's, I don't know. I'm thinking about retirement. It's all depends. You know, last fight it was difficult. The eye injury gets you to think. But let's say if I win all four fights, you know, then you think differently. But I got nothing to prove, I feel. And then I'm gonna. Yeah, I don't know. We see. After four fights, then I see. But like I said, I'm very happy with Bellator. Even after four fights. I'm not gonna go anywhere.
Kijk, wat heb je meegekregen van Costello's gevecht? Heb je die nog gekeken?
Ja, ik heb live in het hotel. Dus we hebben allemaal gekeken. We zijn heel trots op hem.
Ja.
Ik houd de gordel warm voor hem. Nog 2-3 jaar is en dan mag hij het hebben.
Ja.
En dan heeft hij ook een paar wedstrijden daarna. Dus dat zijn duur.
Ik hoorde dat je al bij de stare-down al gevoel kreeg van dat het wel goed zat.
Years of third down, I was zo verzekerd. Maar bij de weging, ogen liggen niet soms. En je zag dat hij nerveus was. En dat gaf me een boost. Ik sliep lekkerder.
Yeah.
Ik heb 7 uur achter elkaar geslapen, dat gebeurt niet vaak. Gewoon het dierengedrag. Je ziet angst en dan word je wat feller.
Dus als ik hem nog wel. Ja.